guys, so we are still on Block Show Europe. The event is finishing and I met a really interesting person. His name is Kuman. He's from Iran and he's presenting a world food program and the blockchain program, right? He's working on blockchain project. So I would like you please tell us about your company and what you're doing there, especially about the blockchain.
So the World Food Program is the UN's food agency. Traditionally, when people have been hungry, we've assisted them by providing in-kind food. But for a few years now, we're empowering the beneficiaries to purchase their own items, a concept called cash-based transfers. So we could either distribute physical banknotes, prepaid cards, mobile money, vouchers, it takes many forms, but that's the concept. And one of the issues we face is that there's normally a high cost associated to these transfer modalities by whoever the intermediary is. And our idea is essentially to use the blockchain to account for all the transactions and then pay out to the end merchants, for example, for the moment with regular currencies, fiat currencies, but down the line also through cryptocurrencies. And we'll certainly save money. We will have our own version of records and realities, so our reconciliation will be easier, our risk will be lower, and we can better protect beneficiary data.
Right. So I would like to ask you, what do you think of bringing kind of from bank population to the global economy and to their, so the people from emerging countries that you might be working with as well. So our mission is to bring them to the economy with our application and our wallet. And I would like to know your opinion of how is it, if it is important for people like that, is it important to have some kind of way of, find a way to
put
your currency and blockchain?
Well, certainly. Many of our beneficiaries, in fact, are unbanked, and there is many obstacles to it. So, for example, banks may not be interested in banking with them because maybe it's not profitable.
Right.
In other areas, there is the issue also of identity, that it's difficult to even prove who you are, maybe in the case of refugees and all of that. And the banking system is a requirement of modern life. When you're unbanked, you can't participate in society or many facets of it the way other people could do. And also in a lot of such populations, in the case of migrant workers, where somebody from the family goes abroad to work and send money back, if they're unbanked, a very high percentage of the transfer value for somebody who could probably least afford it goes to the transfer itself, because it has to be through other mechanisms. So definitely, you know, being able to bring people on and connect them with the form of banking, which I think is what you guys are doing too, is a very noble and important cause and worth pursuing. And the blockchain itself also, like, it really removes the obstacles or the excuses for people not to collaborate together, because it's not a one person thing. Everyone has to come together for food, for money, for shelter, for health. And we're also really hoping that through the blockchain project that we've initiated, but generally blockchain as a concept would foster more collaboration between various humanitarian organizations, UN or not.
Thank you so much. It was really interesting to hear your opinion, and thank you for coming to Block Show.
Thank you very much.